Everybody, you're welcome to my page, your channel again. Yes, again. So I promised I was going to do a video to on breastfeeding, the correct positioning and latching. Yes, to celebrate August, which is the breastfeeding awareness month. We know that if you are not positioned correctly to breastfeed, you might be hurting yourself. If you are not sitting well, if you're not comfortable and breastfeeding, you end up having shoulder pain, especially under your shoulder blades, and you have back aches as well, or waist pain. So it's very, very important that you are positioned right, you are positioned well, you are holding your baby or carrying your baby well to breastfeed. So I'm going to demonstrate how to breastfeed properly. And please note that all what I'm showing you, all what I'm telling you, is what I've learned from community nurses and midwives, child care nurses as well. And I used what I was taught to take care to nurse baby D, and it really worked for me. Although you have to consciously remember, because, you know, as African women, we just, you know, maybe it's breastfeeding. Just carry the baby and breastfeed now, put the breast in the mouth of the baby, you know. But there is a better way to doing it. It might take a while for us to get used to it, but if you're able to do it that way, it will really relieve you of a whole lot of backache and body pain at the end of it all. So I'll demonstrate. For lack of getting better props, I'll be using our hands-free bottle holder. And I have a pacifier inside to demonstrate or to represent the nipple. Okay, so and then of course I'll be using our dummy baby as our baby. Now, before you start breastfeeding, of course, you know, when your baby starts crying, you're not going to start thinking of all of these things, but by now, as a baby to a newborn mom, you should know the number of how many hours it's going to take before your baby wakes up or is ready for the next feed. So you start preparing yourself, or you make all the things available for breastfeeding at a corner or at a place. Some people have particular places where they breastfeed their children, maybe in the child's room, that's in the nursery, or they have a particular chair. In baby D's room, we have a rocking chair, which I had used anyway. But yeah, I had pillows all around. So if I wanted to breastfeed in the living room or wanted to breastfeed in his room, I had things and props that made it easy and convenient for me. So what I usually do for you to want to breastfeed, when you're getting ready to breastfeed, you know where you're going to breastfeed. So you are very important. The baby too is important, but you're very important. So you have to make sure that you are sitting well. What I usually do when I want to breastfeed is either I'm sitting on the bed so that my legs are off the ground, so my legs to my waist are at the same level, the same height. Or if I'm breastfeeding in the living room, I raise my legs and put my legs on an ottoman. So that makes it really, really convenient for me. I also have pillows. They are nursing pillows, but if you cannot afford the nursing pillow, you can get the regular throw pillows and put them at the side that you're going to be breastfeeding. So let's assume you're breastfeeding the left side. You know, to just make it easier, just have pillows on your left and on your right to raise your hands. Because number one mistake that we usually make as breastfeeding mothers is that you're carrying your breast to your baby. No, you're supposed to bring your baby towards your breast, not the other way. Because if you're carrying your, taking your breast to your baby, you end up slouching and you end up, you know, bending your back so many times. Imagine breastfeeding 8 times in a day and you're slouching 8 times in a day. Eventually, it's going to give you bad posture and it's going to give you body pain. Okay, so you have to put that into consideration. Okay, to try and find a very comfortable chair. Let the height be equal. If you're going to raise your legs, let it be that the height is, you know, the same height with your leg and your waist. If you're going to put your legs down, you can fold your legs. Just find a comfortable position for you and use as many pillows to support your arms as much as possible. If you are using a chair, let the chair have an arm rest. On has a arm as arm rest that I can support my arms on. Okay, so I'm going to get ready to show us how to do the breastfeeding thing. So because I have the arm rest here, I don't really need pillows to prop myself up. Okay. So I am comfortable. I am okay. I'm sure I can sit like this for 20 minutes without having any issues. Then I carry my baby. Okay. Yep. So for correct positioning of your baby, this is how it should be done. Your baby should be positioned facing you. Your baby should not be like this. Your baby should be facing you. So what you do is, the chest of your baby is towards your own chest. The tummy of your baby is towards your own tummy. So I'm resting my hand and I bring the nip, I bring my baby towards my breast. Not me bringing my breast towards my baby and I'm slouching. I'm sitting upright and I'm comfortable and I'm bringing my baby towards. So chest to chest, tummy to tummy. If you do it that way, it's really, really going to be convenient for you. It's going to be easy. So that's the correct way to position your baby. Now, to breastfeed your baby, for newborn babies, babies are born with the instinct to find their food. So they can locate the nipple, they can locate the breast, they can locate, because they can perceive the smell of the milk, so they can locate it. So what you do, I'm going to bring this out now. So let's say this is your nipple. What you're going to do is that you take your nipple like this and tilt it upwards. And you're tilting your nipple upwards towards